judge, this year's series of The Bachelor gets down to the finals. Last year's most eligible man has proved to critics that true love really can come from a reality TV show. And he joins us now at Studio 10. Let's welcome Tim Robards, everyone.
Hey, Tim, how are you?
Yeah, good.
You're quite shacked up with gorgeous Anna. You know, you've done up your apartment.
Is it all just a hoax, Tim? Be honest.
Oh, they don't pay me enough for that.
I've got to say, I am impressed because I was a little bit sus about you.
Yeah, I was sus about myself.
Oh, no, no, but Jess. No,
what do you mean, Jess?
No, no, but just in terms of the whole premise of dating all these beautiful girls and stuff.
Yeah, it was such a different way to find love, and I was a bit sus about the whole thing myself, but went in with the right intention and it worked out well.
So that's I think that's lovely.
Yeah. I reckon it's gonna be I reckon you're gonna get engaged at Christmas.
We just caught up with my grandma actually on the weekend.
Oh, really?
And she's giving me the little nudge. She's like, you know, Tim, I think it is time to get engaged. So
how long have you been going out now?
It's been just over a year now. So.
Oh, that's too soon. You've got to go travel somewhere difficult. You have to challenge yourselves.
That's right. And of course, we have to time it with Channel 10's new upcoming series, The Engagement.
Newlyweds. That would be a really good reality show. Newlyweds.
Yeah.
It did well for Jessica Simpson.
Because you are living together. She's moved into your bachelor pad, hasn't she? Because the living room guys.
So Anna's never lived out of home, so that's been a good learning period for her, you know, just to learn how to take the rubbish down and do all those sort of things.
Oh,
that
you're staring us up. Things
they need to know.
I thought I was starting to like you, and then you say something like that. Goodness me.
We love taking the mickey out of each other. So,
Now, what about this year's series? What do you think about how Blake's going? And
there's been some big characters on this year's series. It's been entertaining to watch. I think, you know, he seems like he's there for the right reason, and judging from the little sneak peek he got last week, looks like he gets engaged.
Yes, so, it looks like he proposes.
Yeah, which he's beat me to it. But
Do you watch him doing all those things? And because you obviously are one of the very few people in the world who know exactly what he's going through. Do you go, no, don't do it, you make a terrible mistake, or sort of?
There's a couple of things where you're like, yeah, I want, you know, but and the girls, you know how it works behind the scenes, but it is, at the end of the day, it is real, even though you're filming a show, and you just keep it as real as you can. And
can you tell the girls that are good from the girls that are trouble? Like, do you have a special sort of main line into their goals?
Does any man have that ability?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
I'm still trying to figure them out, but you know.
All right, well,
And now you're getting totally, because you've got a physique, I don't know if you can zoom up on Tim's body, but it's very similar to mine. And I understand you're getting ready for this ridiculous extreme sport event.
This is taking us back to our warrior roots, you know, where running through the bush and getting dirty and all that was just a way of life. So it's just reminding us
It's called the Spartan race.
In the hunter and gatherer days.
Right.
Look at that.
Maybe a couple of thousand years ago.
Right. Yeah. Is that a Bondi? Can we see that photo again?
It's incredible. Someone has actually photoshopped Tim's face onto my body.
That is amazing. So this is basically, it's a run. So there's a 7 kilometre run and a 14 kilometre run. And they put some obstacles in the way. So you've got to climb over things, jump under things, climb
through
mud.
What do you mean an obstacle? Like an elephant?
Kind of like
broken glass?
Basically walls and mud and streams and rivers and things like that. So
a guy with a stop sign?
That's right. King's Cross bouncers.
Yeah.
They have a few guys with some big pads. I think they run out some Spartan-looking guys.
Do men and women both compete in this race or just men?
I've actually got Anna's going to... She's going to do the 7K one.
Is this a bit of a test for her, mate?
If she gets to the end, then you never know who will be there waiting for her with...
You're doing the test for her, I think.
She tests me out all the time.
It's called the Sparta Race Australia, and you reckon anyone can take part in it?
Yep, definitely. It's something, as long as, you know, it's the smaller one's a 7 kilometre walk, so as long as you can walk or run it, you know.
Can our roving reporter Robbo, can he walk? I think he can. Look at him.
Only just.
He's a bit small. He could do it.
There we go.
Reckon you could finish the Spartan race, Robbo?
Well, I think I could, Sarah. And Tim had me at warrior roots and getting down and dirty. So as soon as he said that, I'm ready to go. And you know, I'm sure it's going to be a piece of cake. So let's do this. Let's get into some mud with me and Tim.
Just a quick sort of test, Robbo. Can you actually touch your toes?
Why would you ask me that?
What? Well, just show us yes. now. Can we see?
Yeah. That. Yeah. 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 Hey, yeah. He's sweet as a nut. Yeah.
He's ready.
All right, so you're off to compete, Robbo, on October 11 in the Spartan race. See if we can keep up with Tim. That'd be hilarious to watch.
Is it for a charity?
They are raising some money for a charity. I think there's a few different charities, so different people are running for different things. So.
And you're going to train Robbo up, are you?
Yeah, we've got 2 weeks. Whoa. So get him on the chin-up bars down in Bondi.
Brilliant. Tim, thank you so much for coming in. Say hello to Anna for us.
Thank you.